for your favorite diva first elimination Tuesday night.
We're back here in Oklahoma, and Oklahoma native Jack Swagger has been waiting for this night ever since becoming a WWE superstar.
Put on your black hats and stand up. Here he comes. A two-time collegiate academic All-American.
What's this?
What a rush. It's a hawk.
Only fitting for a king, an eagle, to accompany the king to the ring. Come on, guys, stand up and show this man your support.
Jack Swagger's a 2002 Heisman Trophy finalist. I bet you Carson Palmer should give that trophy back right now.
Look at Jack. Look at how regal he looks here tonight.
Has a degree in finance, the first high school athlete nominated for an ESPY. At 16 years old, Jack Swagger was granted early admission into the University of Oklahoma. Todd, what college did you go to?
West Georgia University.
Oh, yeah? Did you get late admission?
I graduated.
Okay.
There's the eagle. The eagle has landed.
Yes.
He's very agile as well.
Of course, Jack is the All-American American. There's nothing more American than an eagle. Hi, Jack.
He's got Harley Race's
club,
too. Hey, buddy.
All right, there he is.
Hey, Todd, he doesn't look at you at all. I know it's very beautiful. What is that, velvet?
And they say you couldn't come home. Thank you, Oklahoma. Thank you. I mean, what would the premiere of Friday Night SmackDown on the Sci-Fi Network in Oklahoma City be without Oklahoma's own, the All-American American Jack Swagger? Thank you. Now, I have a huge announcement tonight. Huge announcement. It truly is going to be a great day in the history of Oklahoma. But before I get there, I just got something I need to say. I have a problem with every single Oklahoman in this building. I have a problem with the state of Oklahoma.
I'm with you on that.
I put Oklahoma on the map, and when I return to my state, I don't even get a Jack Swagger parade.
Yeah.
Where's my proclamation of a Jack Swagger day? I mean, they haven't even given me the key to Oklahoma City. What's up with that? That's right. You're absolutely right. That is exactly why me and my personal mascot, the Swagger Soaring Eagle, have moved out of Oklahoma. We've gone to someplace where the people have class, where everything is bigger and therefore better. That's right. Say it with me, Texas.
Yeah, Texas. Way to go, Jack.
Red River Shootout.
Everybody, God bless Texas.
Wow, Red River Jack causing a commotion here in his hometown, former hometown.
I'm from Texas, and
Texas,
I love Jack to be my neighbor.
Winners, because Texas is going to prove that tomorrow when Texas defeats Oklahoma.
Yeah, hook 'em horns.
Would you quit cheerleading?
Talk about college football game tomorrow.
Don't even go to the game because it's going to be a Texas blowout.
Hook 'em horns.
And despite the fact that you people didn't throw me a parade or proclaim a Jack Swagger day, me and the Swagger Soaring Eagle here are going to be the bigger man. I'm still going to continue to proclaim and give back to Oklahoma because I am a leader, I am a role model, I am one of the people, I am your king. And there's only one person qualified for this coronation. So by the power invested in Swagger, I hereby proclaim myself the official undisputed king of Oklahoma.
Oh, there he is, the king of Oklahoma. I could think of better places to be king of, but nonetheless.
Now get on your knees and worship me.
There's a monarch, rules with an iron fist.
You ungrateful Sooners, worship me.
You think you know me?
Thank God. Another Raw superstar. Cole Edge has gone off the deep end. I think he was beating up electronics on Monday Night Raw, wasn't he?
Well, Edge has had a major issue with the anonymous general manager on Monday Night Raw. This past week, it got so bad when the general manager reversed the decision in Edge's match versus John Cena. Edge attacked the computer. The GM sends me his emails
Edge.
On. He
Edge.
Attacked the computer.
This is my coronation. Cut the music. Edge, we're kind of busy here. These people were in the process of worshiping me. See, they don't like you out here, so pay no attention to Edge. Please continue.
No, you see, they're not gonna continue. You see, after I was involved with that ridiculousness with the computer last Monday on Raw, I told myself I was gonna go on a mission here in the WWE. Yeah, a mission of epic proportions, a mission that would rid the WWE landscape, Raw, SmackDown, it doesn't matter, rid it of anything that is stupid.
See you, Michael. Bye-bye.
Stupid. Bro, I got my own personal mascot. That's not stupid. That's cool.
Well, seriously, the mascot is ridiculous.
Do not talk that way about the Swagger Soaring Eagle.
The fact that you named it the Swagger Soaring Eagle is stupid.
That's real nice. That's real nice.
This podium is stupid. That stupid cape is stupid. That stupid crown is stupid. So I tell you what, Swagger, I'm going to start my mission right now.
It's an endangered species. Be careful.
Who, Swagger?
No, the Eagle. Edge has held every major championship in the WWE, a high-risk, high-reward superstar.
So that gives him the right to come out here and do this.
Why not? He's earned his right.
You know, we were just happy anyone came.
Oh! Now that was stupid.
He punched him in the beak.
It's the Swagger Dead Eagle.
That's my Eagle.
And the coronation ceremony has taken a terrible turn for Swagger.
Edge's mission to vanquish stupidity begins here on Friday Night SmackDown.
Yeah, but come on, this is a travesty of justice. This is supposed to be the land of the free.
Well, hang on.
Freedom of speech.
Wait a minute. Edge is a guy that has earned his way here in the WWE for so many years.
Hold on. The Eagle is rising up like a phoenix.
Rising up? What do you want? What show are you
well,
on?
Well, if he's rising up, he's about to be punctured down. I sense a spear coming.
Oh, don't do this. Come on. No, Edge.
Let's see. Feathers.
No!
Spear.
Dead bird.
Put some barbecue sauce on it. Swagger's return to Oklahoma is not exactly what he had hoped. Michael, you either. That's just